y'all. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Shantae Marie here, and today I am going to be discussing 5 things that I feel are very important and also kind of things that I noticed that happened when I was at basic training that I was like, really? So hopefully they will be helpful. If you would like to learn more, make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel by going ahead and clicking the button below, and also make sure to turn on notifications so that you can get the updates every single time that they happen. Whew, that was my first time saying that, and that was a little bit difficult, but I feel like I need to start saying it because I never say it, and that's what I feel like I need to do. So numero uno is going to be joining for the wrong reasons. There are so many people who join the military for the wrong reasons, and a lot of people probably have biased opinions as to what the right reason is and what the wrong reason is. And really, when it all comes down to it, it's about you as a person and what you want to get out of the military. And I'm not saying that as it being a bad thing for you to want to receive some sort of benefit for the military, but let's face it, every single job that a person does in the world, whether it's military or civilian, you want to receive some type of a benefit. What's the point in doing a job if you don't get any benefits out of it? That would be like taking a job knowing good and well that you don't ever get a day of leave or ever get a day off of work. Like, nobody's gonna do that. So you wanna make sure that you're joining for the right reasons. Mine was initially for college, but on top of that, I just have a really big sense of patriotism that runs through my blood. I feel like it's been instilled in me since I was younger. I just have grown up that way. A lot of people don't have that, and their first thought process is, crap, I'm about to be out in the real world, what am I gonna do? Or crap, I can't find a job, what am I gonna do? You have to really sit and think and ask yourself if committing however many years of your life is worth it, because there are so many people that I come across in the military who are like, I joined just because I needed a job and I hate this, and they sit there and hate their life and hate their life and hate their life, and that really shows and kind of trickles in to the rest of the people who are in the military. There's gonna be someone somewhere who looks up to you, and if you join for the wrong reasons, it's definitely going to show. I think that if you are considering joining the military or you are getting ready to ship off to basic training, you need to really evaluate the reason why you joined. And instead of looking at things in a negative light all the time, if you feel like you made a mistake joining, try and find some sort of a benefit and flip it around and make it work in your favor. You can hate your job every single day of your life, but if you are making sure that you reap the benefits that you want to see, it's going to help you in the long run. Chucking up the deuces. Number two is going to be complaining. Complaining is definitely something that I feel like I've heard on many YouTube videos about the military, but a lot of people have the misconception that it's only females who complain, which I have an issue with that, because I can honestly say everybody in the military complains about something. It's who you complain about it to that is going to cause you issues in the long run. So when I go to work and stuff, I may sit and complain about stuff, but I know who it is that I can complain to, who it is that I can't complain to, who it is that I can talk about certain things with, and who I can't. You need to make sure that you understand your surroundings and know who it is that you are associating with. Know who's in earshot, because it's honestly disheartening that people really have the perception that females are the only ones who be sitting at basic training complaining, because you cannot tell me that men were not in the barracks bitching and moaning about whatever the F they had going on. Like, I know that that's a lie. So when you're at basic training, everybody's going to complain. Everybody's gonna feel some type of way about something. You're going to complain because your battle buddies are gonna fuck up, and that's gonna end up getting everyone in trouble, not just you. If you get in trouble, everyone's going down with you. So You need to make sure that if you are complaining, you do it around the people that you know aren't going to be like, you just a whiny baby all the time. And let's lessen the damper of it only being females who complain. Because I know good and well that there's some bitchy ass men out there. I just know. So you definitely shouldn't complain, but it's just the nature. It's the nature of the job. It's the nature of the military. There's going to be things that you don't like and you're going to complain. So just be smart about who you talk about it with. Number three is humble yourself.
Nobody pray for me. It been a day for me.
I'm going to repeat myself one more time. You need to humble yourself. Bitch, sit down and humble yourself. Like, if I could put this on a board for every single person who ever goes into a MET station to humble yourself before you sign a damn thing, it would mean so much more. Because even if you feel like you're a humble person, you're gonna have something happen to you that makes you be like, I was not as humble as I once thought I was. Like, I had that moment. I feel like I am one of the humblest people in the world, but I remember just being in a climate of a bunch of people from all over the world that you do not know. Like, when I went to basic training, there were people who joined the military so they could get their US citizenship. There were people who came from dirt poor families. We're all mixed together as one, especially when you're at basic. There's going to be people that you don't know. You don't know how they were raised, their background, their culture. You have to humble yourself to be willing to take all of that in and be able to really thrive in the environment. If you do not do that, you're gonna struggle, because when it all comes down to it, male and females alike, you are a team. Like, your platoon that you get tossed into at basic training is a team. And if you all don't click and don't work together, you're gonna have one hell of a time at basic training, because the drill sergeants are gonna eat you alive. And it is no joke at all. So you have to make sure that you humble yourself before you even hop into that environment, because otherwise, it's gonna be the most miserable 2 months of your damn life. Number four is remaining an individual. Making sure that you don't continue to conduct yourself as an individual. The moment that you head into that MET station, you should start getting in the mindset of like, this is a team. Whether you see those people at METs again or not, at the end of the day, those are your brothers and sisters in arms. And this goes for every single branch. I am Army National Guard, but even though I'm Army, these are people that you could potentially be deployed with overseas. We make up 1% of people. Like, these are your brothers and sisters. You need to know that even if you don't personally know that person, you can trust them. You probably will hear it a million times at basic training that someone's being a blue falcon. That means that you're literally fucking your battle buddies. Like, you're literally doing your own damn thing, not giving two shits about anyone else but yourself. So you may as well just take it upon yourself to not be an individual the moment that you decide that you want to step into a MET station, because that's just not the way that the military works. You're gonna have to have battle buddies everywhere you go that kind of like instills it in you when you're at basic, because you can't do anything alone anyway. You can't even take a dump alone. You gotta have someone with you all the time. And then you joined the military for a reason, but everybody is growing from this experience. So the stuff you did in high school, the stuff that you may have been doing before you joined if you weren't in high school, that stuff kind of like flies out the window the moment you put the uniform on. Like, your friends at home might be doing drugs, drinking all the time, doing all this stuff. You are going somewhere to change yourself. And you're doing something that's above and beyond that. And I came from a little tiny town and didn't really realize that, and it didn't really hit me until like I was actually at Fort Jackson and I was like, well, damn, like None of the people in my hometown like talk about any of this stuff. That's because you are doing something so different from those people in your past. So you may go home and talk about it, discuss it with people, whatever. But at the end of the day, you need to make sure that you're not just going back to that. That's how people get done with basic and AIT and go back and get fat. And go back and do things that they get in trouble with the law. Those are two separate lives, and that's something that you kind of have to realize and get through your head. The last tip that I'm gonna give you guys is try to not be scared. A lot of people go to basic training and are just scared. I can't even tell you the number of people that I would talk to that it was like, if you're obviously gonna be nervous. I was nervous. I remember being on the plane and I was like, dang, are we there yet? And we weren't even close to being there yet. So it's okay to feel nervous, but try and remind yourself not to be scared to where it interferes with the purpose of you being there. The purpose of you being on the way to basic training and getting ready to go through that process is because you are doing something for yourself, for your country. If you're National Guard, you're doing it for your state as well. You are bettering yourself and you're not doing it alone. There's hundreds of people there that are doing it with you. Any mistake that you make when you're at basic training, you have to remind yourself that these mistakes are going to make you better in the long run. Like accidentally whining about something and the drill sergeant overhears you. When that drill sergeant rips your ass a new one, you are going to be so thankful for that when you get into the real swing of the military, because little things like that, that you're like, dang, my drill sergeant really walked in and flipped my bunk because I had a sock laying on the bed. It seems so terrible at the time when you're at basic, but when you get done, one, that's a funny ass story that you're gonna tell everyone for the rest of your life. These things are gonna be coming up even if you do your years and get out. You're still gonna be telling people you laid a sock on your bed and your drill sergeant flipped the bed on you and ruined it, and the whole bay had to go fix their beds. It's little things like that that are going to make you such a better soldier in the long run. And I know it probably doesn't seem like it now, and you're probably like, girl, how is a sock gonna change my life? But I promise you, in the long run, you're really going to see that it made you a better soldier, because you had the discipline to know the next time, I ain't leaving my sock on this bed, because then I'm not gonna get in trouble. And then later on, the drill sergeant finds something else, like your shoes, your bootlaces weren't tucked into your boots, and then they knock everything off anyways. But still, moral of the story, you get what I'm trying to say. So if you guys have questions, leave them in the comments section. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure that you let me know what other videos that you guys want to see. Thanks again for coming to my channel, guys, and I will see you in the next one.